Hello and welcome to Straight Up Tech. Let's learn together. I hope you learned to control the movement of the player from our last episode. Now we will dive into another basic aspect of game development, that is the camera movement. As always, before we start, please don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon so you never miss a video again. Now, as we know, the skybox is added by default, which imitates the sky in your game, and also add the light source. You can control the light source from the rational light. Here I like to keep it something like 60, position 0, position 0. So this kind of focuses on the player and the light is very well maintained. After that, let's talk about the camera movements. Now, camera movements, like anything else in the game development, can be done in many ways. Perhaps the most common method will be to make the camera a child of the player. Again, click on main camera and make it a child of a player. So this means now wherever we go and move a player, the camera will move with it. See, the camera is moving with the player. Though most basic setup for camera movement, it comes with its own set of problems. Now if we go ahead and rotate our player, see, when you rotate our player, then the camera will rotate with it. This might be what you need for a game, but for game in which things collide or the player falls off a cliff, this setup will make the camera rotate with the player and make things confusing. So to counter the problem, we unparent the player and make a script to control the camera movement. So what we'll do is we'll move the camera back here, and then create a script. So now, before creating any script, let me explain to you what we are gonna do now. We want the camera to follow our player, but not as a child, because of the confusion it will cause. So to achieve this, we will create a public variable player from which we can reference our player game object, and a private vector 3 variable offset, which we were setting it as private because we want to set it here inside the script only. Now in this offset variable, we will calculate the difference of position between our player object and camera object, and update the position of our camera object accordingly so our camera follows our player from a fixed distance. So now we create a new script by going to components, add component, and then new script. We'll name our script cam controller and create an add. We'll put this cam controller inside the script and then open the script. First of all, we'll create a public variable of game object. Name it player and a private vector 3 variable, and we name it offset. Now in this start, we will initialize this offset value with the current position of the player. Transform from dot position, close the parenthesis. Now we will write void late while let update and write something transform dot position equals to player dot transform dot position plus offset. We'll save the script and we'll go back to Unity. A component named player in this can control script. We'll move a player and drag it to the script. Let me set this back to straighten this up. Move our camera a bit like this, so we're directly behind our player, and then press play. And you can see how our camera follows the player around, and even if a player falls off the edge or is collided with other object, the camera does not rotate with the player, thus creating no more confusion. So play around with camera controls. This is all for today, and don't forget to subscribe or click on bell icon so you never miss a video from us again. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.